Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? In the evening sky, I do want to quickly point out that since January, we have an evening visitor. And so if we go from January 15th and click our way forward across a month or so, we have Jupiter that's rising. And Jupiter is well up at this point. It's a good 20 degrees up by 9 o'clock. In the evening sky, so definitely give that a look. It's going to get even more prominent as it goes towards opposition in a little less than a month or so. But because this week is largely full of the moon, let's focus on that. On the 16th, we have a slightly past first quarter phase, and the Montes Apenninus are quite prominent here in the just above the equator in the northern section of the moon. But I do want to kind of click ahead because even though we've got some great craters visible down here, I know a lot of people are going to be viewing this later in the week. So we'll look at some of the things that could be seen in that time period. You can see how Montes Apenninus is still shadowed partially, and that's going to still make for a good target for you to look at. But out at the end of that is a crater called Eratosthenes that's 58 kilometers wide. It's about 3.5 kilometers deep, and you can see that deep shadow as the sunlight kind of comes over the edge of that and really makes for a nice view of that particular crater. If we look up and above the Mare Imbrium region, which is kind of where Eratosthenes is on the southern end of that, the crater are actually more of a walled plain. Plato is up there, and Plato is 100 kilometers across, so about 100 or 60 miles or so. So it's a pretty good sized feature, and there's a number of small craters in there, so if you do have steady seeing, then bump up your magnification and see if you can see those small craters in there. That's a good time to look for that on the 16th. And one other crater I do want to kind of point out, because you're going to see this become more prominent as we go in towards full moon, is this crater right here. See how deep that is? Or deep appearing that is. It's got this really shadowed section, even though it's in a fairly lit portion of the moon compared to some of the other craters. That's Tycho, and Tycho is where you see those bright rays kind of coming out as the moon gets more towards full phase. And we can even see Tycho here. You can see the central peak is nicely shadowed a little bit, along with still having some shadow of the crater there on the 17th. So do look for that. As we move into that day, though, we continue on from Montes Apenninus past Eratosthenes. We get to Copernicus. That's 93 kilometers in diameter. It's about 3.7 kilometers deep. And it has some central peaks that are over a kilometer in height. So that particular crater also has a lot of rays around it. You can even see some of those here kind of going up this direction, down here, and even out towards the eastern portion of the moon, even despite not having the phase being towards full. If we move down towards the southern portion of the moon, this particular feature right in here, and I'm going to zoom in a little bit on this, right here, this is Longomontanus. This is a walled plain that's 145 kilometers across, so it's very large. And you can actually see, it looks like when this was formed, it probably obliterated another portion or a good portion of another crater perhaps beneath it. You can see kind of this crescent shape where that's deeper than this area here. And the last thing that I wanted to point out for the 17th is this large walled plain, which is Clavius, and you can see the very number of very small craters within that, and then that shadowed section of the walled plain of Clavius. Clavius is 225 kilometers across. So that's about the largest object that we're going to look at, other than some of the maria that are on the moon. If we click ahead to the 18th, we've got Montes Jura, and these are up here, up by Sinus Iridum, which is a portion of, kind of goes off of Mare Imbrium, which is this very large dark section of the moon. And right at this portion, I'll zoom in on this a little bit too, you can see Montes Jura goes here, and then there's this crater called Bianchini, That's a small crater that's just 39 kilometers across. So even though that's really relatively large, I mean, 39 kilometers is not exactly a small distance, but it looks small compared to a lot of the other features that we would see. So look for that on the 18th. And we can also, when we scoot down towards the southern portion of the moon, look at how Gassendi looks over here. We've got these walled sections over on the eastern side, and then on the western side, kind of the broken walls that are just showing portions of it. And this little area right there, that's Gassendi A. That's a fairly small crater that's just 33 kilometers across, but it's 3.6 kilometers deep. So that's a neat area to check out on the 18th. On the 19th, we have the crater Mersenius, and I will zoom in again on this area. Here's Gassendi again, and there's Gassendi A. Here's the walls of Gassendi and its central peak. But this particular crater is a neat one to look at. This is Mersenius. It's a flooded crater, and it has a convex floor at 82 kilometers across. You can even kind of see that, how the shadow in there really shows not exactly the same type of view that we've seen from some of the other larger deep craters that are there. So that's a great area to check out on the 19th. Towards the north, here's, of course, one of my favorite craters, Aristarchus, which I always enjoy looking at. This is not necessarily the greatest view of it, but it's a decent time to at least take a look at that area. But I do want to show what's happening up here, because this is really kind of an interesting look. We've got the crater Herschel formed here, and you can see kind of the southern walls here, and here's the north and western section. But up above there, these two craters, which are Anaximander and Carpenter, kind of form this cutout. You can see how this portion of Anaximander is just sort of stops, and then Carpenter is sort of overlapping that, and there's this big, deep black cutout there, which is kind of a really cool look on the northern part of the moon. When we scoot that ahead a day, can zoom back in and then see those craters. Here's Herschel again, and here's Anaximander and Carpenter. But now, just slightly south and west of there, we've got Pythagoras. And yes, the Pythagorean theorem was named after Pythagoras, the mathematician who came up with that particular equation. Pythagoras is 128 kilometers across, and the rim there is lit by sunlight, but the entire plane itself of the crater is dark. So check that out on the 20th. And we can also look on the eastern side of the moon. You can see how Mare Marginis and Mare Smithi are visible because the moon has librated due to libration, and we can kind of peek around that eastern edge of the moon. So look at those on the 20th. And then on the 21st, we still have those Mare over there that you can see. The moon is nearly full at this point, but there's still a couple things to be able to see. If we zoom back in over on Pythagoras, we can actually see the central peak of that crater now. And we end up with a lot of washed out stuff. This is where Herschel is. It looks almost very difficult to see now. Anaximander and Carpenter are not nearly as lit, or much more lit, excuse me. And Pythagoras is the interesting feature there. We've got some other craters right here, kind of right along the Terminator, that are good things to look at as well. And here is where Copernicus is in the center, and I mentioned Tycho towards the beginning of this video, and there's Tycho right kind of in the center of the southern portion of the moon, and you can see how all those rays go out from there to give you a really cool view there. So that's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.